And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube who's watching this video later on over there for another special stream today. We got a sub battle stream day. So what we're going to be doing here is each last Saturday of the month. Each last Saturday? There's only one last Saturday of every month. But anyway, the last Saturday of the month, we're going to be doing, that's going to be the day that we're going to be doing our sub battle stream every single month. So you can kind of put it on the schedule. Plan for it and everything. Always the last Saturday. That's our sub battle day. This is a really fun day. How this works is I'm going to be playing against subscribers here in the Twitch chat throughout the entire stream today. We'll kind of break it down into three parts for the YouTube channel here, so it's not just one long 7-hour stream kind of thing. I have a wheel that I will spin that has 30 decks on it that have been just decks that we've played here on stream before. So we got 30 decks that I just spin to see what deck I'm playing, and the subscriber who I'm playing against will just also, you know, bring their favorite deck. And so I'm playing different decks every round. The subscribers are bringing their own cool decks. We've had a couple of times that we've seen some really cool new decks that subscribers have brought that we've then played on stream a couple following days after that. But here we go. This is our last thing to do here with War of the Spark Standard. Then I'll be taking the next 2 days off, Sunday and Monday, to kind of rest, recuperate, and get ready for M20 that comes on Tuesday. And then I'll be doing a 12-hour stream on Tuesday there. Okay. All right. So how this works is we're going to see who is ready to play. If you're ready, if you are a subscriber and ready to battle, it looks like we already got some people in there. Just type the word battle into the chat. We'll determine who's going to be the first person to play. So let's go ahead and, looks like everybody's in there. Let's see who we got. All right, J-Jack Jr. J-Jack Jr., you're up first. So send me your gamer tag. And there's my gamer tag right there. All right, we'll see what deck I'm going to be playing here to start with. You can kind of tell my voice is a little shot, a little tired after talking for the, you know, 10-ish hours yesterday for the set review. I like doing the set reviews a whole lot though, but I may need to break them into 2 days. All right, we got Sultai Control. So Sultai Control. To kind of show the deck here first before we start playing it, is it looks like this. It is, well, the Kefnets really should be main in the Ashiok's board. We'll just change that. There we go. So we're just trying to, like, Assassin's Trophy, Casualties of War, kill a bunch of things, use Tamiyo to get those things back, and kind of grind out the wins with that. All right, thank you, J-Jack. So make sure you have it set on best of three coin flip challenge match. And here we go. Yeah, Sir Tails, with the set review, I am pretty tough on, like, the grading system is pretty tough. Like, basically, if it's a good solid standard card, you know, you're looking at like the C range basically. A's are really hard. Like, I don't give out very many A's at all in that. Like, A's are pretty tough in that grading thing. And so maybe I need to adjust my grading scale system, maybe. Yeah, I did when I was a teacher. Yeah, I graded, like, being a math teacher, it's a lot easier, you know, like, you just grade, like, all of my questions, like, the answers were either right or wrong, and, you know, you just give the percentage on that. And, you know, I was very just number based and everything whenever I was a teacher. It wasn't like I wasn't giving subjective grades or anything, so it's not like I was easier or harder than anything. It was just, you know, all the homeworks had problems and I just graded all the homeworks. And And everything. Yeah, most cards in a set are for limited. Yep, there's not usually a ton of standard stuff, and it is a core set and everything. Thank you for the kind words, Orso Mentor. Or, let's see. Orso Minator. Orsometer. Maybe Orsometer. Yeah, and if so, go like if you listen to me talk about some of the cards, like cards that I was giving a low grade to, I was probably giving praise to while I was talking about them and everything, or saying that they were good cards that I liked and stuff like that. Or some Nader. Okay. So yeah, just because like the grade's a little lower doesn't mean it's a card that I wasn't excited about. And so like that's, I've definitely been trying to think of like maybe a better grading system. I know people like, you know, letter grades and things like that, or you know, number scores, or you know, like very easy ways to go through and digest what I think of the cards, but. I've been considering like some other, like, you know, maybe a 3 or 4 tier system of like grading the card on fun and you know, like different, I don't know, different aspects of the card or something. I'm wearing a soul tie for the soul tie deck. There we go. Did you notice that at all, Sir Tails? Like a card that maybe I didn't give a very good grade to, but then sounded higher on whenever I was talking about it? Boom. So Command the Dreadhorde is going to be a difficult card to beat. Thankfully, one's already in the graveyard that we don't have to worry about. Yeah, the L stand for limited. Yep. All right, let's get that thing out of here. Hey Brito, yeah, this is, yep, we're playing a Sultai control deck here. So yeah, we're doing a sub-battle stream here. So I'll be playing a different deck every single round. I got a wheel that I'm spinning. Sultai control is our first deck up for us. And we're playing against subscribers all day. This is a nice, a good fun day. So everybody will be playing their cool decks.
I train F keep an open mind.
Yeah, Underwhelm Lich is definitely difficult to kill. Certainly. certainly difficult to kill.
I have just the trick for this.
Tamiel's good. Tamiel will get us back. The contempt.
The storied past holds our future.
So I took the Thought Erasure a little bit ago because I was thinking that maybe Jack had a Dread Horde in hand and they could only play a Dread Horde or the Lich, and maybe I could Thought Erasure the other one, but. Yeah, about now I wish we would have the Casualties of War instead, of course. Hey, Ben and Donner.
Subject is easily agitated.
Thanks for that sub there. I thought that's a resub. It doesn't say that's a resub, but I feel like you subbed before, Ben and Donner. But thank you very much for that support. Yeah, well, yeah, Casualties of War isn't killing too much right now, but still like that card. Let's get another Narset out here.
The focused and disciplined. Encounter no obstacle. Hone your prowess.
Golgari Queen. Probably taken up. Could kill Narset, but. Okay, we're killing Narset. Yeah, I guess the tick up. The Vraska is going to die anyway. So what do I want here? I want Escanta.
Back to the shadows for now. I follow the tracks of the wise.
So I wouldn't be surprised if Jack Field of Ruins me. At least that's what I'd be doing if I were him, since I surveilled on top here. I think we'd get the Field of Ruins here. Oh, right. Waiting for me to flip the Escanta, though. Right. Right. I don't know why I wasn't really even thinking about Field of Ruin destroying his Kanto. I'm silly. Jace, you're the card I want to draw.
I know I noted this somewhere.
Bunch of other good cards.
We can figure a way out of this. There's always an answer.
I know 88 meditate and prepare.
Alright, so I have 23 cards in library. Take me like 3 turns to mill myself out. But of course, we need to pressure Jjax's life total also here so that a top deck Command the Dreadhorde doesn't go crazy. Yeah, Sultai self mill, or yeah, you can also mill your opponent, but yeah. Yep.
Reckless and ill-refined.
This is like an anti Esper control and anti Nexus deck. Very good in those two matchups.
Let me aid your research.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and just grab our Kefnet back.
Try this.
Put thoughtfulness before action.
So I should just be able to win next turn. All we need is Jjax to whiff here for a turn. Yeah, I just have so much mana. I can just play both these other Tamios this next turn for like the surprise self mill kind of thing. It's like that's 13.
I think you will find my notes helpful.
Abandon all hope. We can't just name like other magic cards. Like that's a card in magic. Abandon all hope. Lame. We'll go Swab Goblin. Wishcoin Crab.
It is an honor to meet you. To the library.
Wishcoin Crab. Name Fibblethip.
Let us see if your talents are worth cataloging. Seek and find.
And there we go. Jace with the win. Alright, so we're playing against Sultai Dreadhorde, so we probably want these Ashioks. And definitely want Unmoored Egos. We want to just get rid of Dreadhorde altogether. We want this extra Ritual of Soot. Yeah, kind of want all those cards. As far as cards that we don't want, I'm not sure. I'm going to take out one trophy. Maybe a couple Narsets, with Narset being pretty vulnerable. A Cry of the Carnarium that doesn't necessarily kill everything. And maybe the Cry of the Carnarium is bringing in the extra Ritual of Soot. We've got to be able to kill... I guess we need Cruelties. I guess we've got to be able to kill Underrealm Lich. Casualties of War... Maybe not as needed, actually, come to think of it. Let's get a Narset back in here. Okay. Yeah, that's true. Fibblethip can't be found. Yeah, usually the name, like, when you're on, like, Magic Online, because Abandon All Hope is a card, and you just name Abandon All Hope. But it's not a card in Standard, and I guess on Arena you can only name cards in Standard. Not any Magic card ever. So good opener for me besides dealing with a lot of early creatures. I don't have creature removal. Yeah, yep, that's the plan for whenever cards rotate out. There's going to be a new format that's called Historic, where you are going to be able to play the cards that rotate out still. Right now, they're not going to be adding in any new sets to Historic, and it's just going to be like the cards that are in Standard right now plus the full set. That's all it's going to be right now.
Not supposed to happen.
Well, we're going to find something for this lich. That doesn't really do it. Gotta exile lich.
It's a matter of give and take.
Doesn't really do it either. So at least we'll be able to flip Azcanta here. We only have three cards that get rid of Lich in the deck. We had the one Contempt last game for two Liches. We were very fortunate there. Just our one of Contempt. We had it once, then we had Tamiyo to get it back. I did bring in two Obnixilus's Cruelties, though, so we have those as well.
I'll plan better next time.
Yeah, I'm really disappointed with the no old sets also. Alright, so Command the Dreadhorde's out of here for good. So we have Big Vivian. We have two Big Vivians left. And two Underrealm Liches left. As the cards that we really need to be scared of. I need to do something about, you know, the whole trying not to die thing, though, also. I'm not sure if I have this specific list up on my stream decker. you know, if I lose this game, we go to sideboarding. You know, you can take a screenshot of it, or after the game. Either way, after this game, either we go to sideboarding, or afterwards, I'll show you the list.
Nightmares themselves fear.
I think Jjax got this one. I mean, I gotta find something for this Underrealm Lich, but we'll clear out everything else.
This!
Not bad.
This has been a nightmare.
Nashiok will just kind of be like a gain four life, you know, give me another turn kind of thing. I got three spells that I need to find. We know it's not none of those. Two Obnoxious Cruelties and one Contempt. Okay, yep. Just attacking me.
I've lost my appetite.
If we draw Kefnet, that would be good too. I was thinking that was Kefnet. Alright, well, there's not any difference between activating as Kanta or playing Narset, so might as well play Narset. Like they both do the thing.
Those who cannot perceive beyond the veil of reality.
I don't have enough mana to Thought Erasure first, so
keep an open mind.
I need this one. Can I take that one? All right, so yeah, this is a list here. Sideboard wise, the two Ashioks and two Obnoxious Cruelties and one of the Ritual Soots, those and the two Unmoored Egos. So those seven cards, these six plus the Ritual Soot, those seven are all main deck. Or sorry, those are all sideboard. The Narset and these Casualties of War and Trophy, that's five. And then the Cry of the Carnarium, six and seven. Those are the other cards that are sideboard. I don't really want two Elder Spells, I don't think. Maybe another Duress? Like, Cry and Moment of Craving are just not very good answers to Underrealm Lich. I guess I'm going to go back and play the fourth Narset. So just another card to dig. Yeah, I would have had to draw the Kefnet for a turn, because then I could Thought Erasure the Chupacabra and then play Kefnet. You know, like I had the mana to do that. So I would have had to draw the Kefnet for turn. Ugh, this is kind of awkward. This is also kind of awkward. I really want to go to five, though. So I guess I'll keep a bunch of blue-green lands and hope we draw black mana. No, I don't do any coaching, Alpha Buddha. I don't. I just do the streaming every day. And while Narset gives you some card advantage, Narset does not help you find black mana. There's black mana, there's black mana. So it's two black sources sent to the bottom. Yes, please Field of Ruin me.
This was overwhelming.
Yeah, J-Jack's looking really good here.
I've seen nothing I can do. Break someone like you.
You've already lost. You just let's think this through.
All right, now we're doing stuff.
Balance comes.
Blast zone. No, I never turned Deckmaster on. Thanks. Is it still broken? It was broken 2 days ago. Okay, it's up now. It looks like it's all looks like it's working. It's working. That's good. Always that chupacabra. Okay, I'm going to need to find Contempt. And or Omnixilus' Cruelty. This Underrealm Lich being an exile-only card with my deck just being full of destroy stuff with trophies and casualties of wars and everything. It's matching up very, very well against me. Hey, say moi, good evening. So yeah, it looks like Blast Zone's gonna destroy both Jace and Kefnet.
That just happened.
That's weird. Gonna go ahead and decline. Cause I'm gonna be activating the Azcanta anyway. just don't. I just don't have any answers. Drew zero answers to Underrealm Lich games 2 and 3. Game one, I was lucky and I drew my one of. Games 2 and 3, I had 3 answers and I drew 0 of them. All right, chat wins the first match. First blood. All right, chat is up 1-0. So if you're a subscriber and you'd like to be the next person to battle here, go ahead and type battle into the chat. Love how excited everybody is. Y'all are great. Hey, good games, J-Jack. Good games. Yeah, just regular battle there. C'est moi, not exclamation point. So say moi if you want to play next. Just make sure you type just battle regularly. There you go. It's okay. You're good. All right, is everybody in there? Okay, let's see who is up next. And it is say moi. There you go. All right. So send me your gamer tag. And there's my gamer tag. And I will be spinning the wheel, letting the wheel decide what deck I'll be playing next. Mardu Midrange. Maybe my favorite deck right now. Alright, so switching over to Mardu Midrange. This is the deck that we're about to play. It's a grindy deck, like where we're trying to bring back a whole lot of 2-drops all the time and everything. With a Johnny and Soren using these cards. It's a pretty sweet little deck. Alright, let's go. You can play anything you want.
Just picked a random deck, you're not prepared? Well,
hopefully you enjoy it and everything. Hey, what's up, Prugar? Good afternoon. That's a really good hand. Yeah, you did well, J-Jack. Good job. All right. Double Dreadhorde Butcher. A card that's at its best when you're on the play. And I'm on the play, and I have him. So certainly a really good hand for me.
Mind and body. Hone your prowess.
Oh no! Didn't even find anything.
You cannot see, folly.
I don't think I really need to worry about a Narset at one, so I just attacked a Narset with the two Butcher. Take away that activation for 2 life. Papa Croft with the tier 1 sub. Welcome to the channel. Thanks for that support, Papa Croft.
chase stokes the forge. No fire, no steel.
So if the Dreadhorde Butcher was a 6-6, you know, it's just a 5-5, but I could have minused on the Dreadhorde Butcher and you know, made myself sacrifice it to deal damage to them. Fortunately, I can't use Chupacabra to kill my own Butcher, because it's destroy a creature an opponent controls. Thanks, Bubbacroft. Well, welcome to the channel. Glad to have you here.
No fire.
All right, Playcrafter will do it. Don't have to worry about a settle or anything. A branch walker. A branch walker. I know. I had a really, really good hand. Poor Seymour there. So I want some black blades. Another Angrath. What's going on over here? It doesn't... I don't know what... what's really going on over here. I'm taking out the Midnight Reapers because it doesn't really seem the creatures are going to die too much. Like one to spark for like a reclamation kind of thing, or Tameo or Nissa or something. This is a lot slower looking hand than, or a lot slower hand than what it looks like with how these lands are lining up for me. Yeah, same Maw had the mold of 5. Alright, well, Jade Light gets to help. Jade Light just redoes that mold of 5 real quick. Draw 2 plus make a 2-1. Kefnet. I guess maybe I was supposed to Chupacabra that thing. I was just kind of already set on playing the Plague Crafter, but maybe I should have Chupacabra'd that.
If you show remorse, I'll show respect. Let's try this. I am here to aid in the assault. I believe in you.
Yeah, looks like, yep, this looks like a Bant Good Stuff deck.
Here goes nothing.
There you go, Prugor. That's a nice... it's a good day ahead.
Prepare for battle.
You just let me know if you're out for round two.
Alright, that's a good card to Daredevil.
Through feud or feast, your blood is mine. I demand servitude.
I should have done lifelink on Chupacabra, I guess. Just tell me to start raining really hard here. Yeah, it did. Just started raiding. Cool, yeah, you're playing the Mario list this morning? Nice. Even though I'm taking tomorrow, you know, like tomorrow and the Sunday, taking the 2 days off, I may, you know, I'm relaxing at home tomorrow, maybe playing some, like I may play the Mario deck and see if I can get in the top 1,000 before it ends tomorrow. I don't think there's really much incentive to get in the top 1,000, honestly, right now. For myself, because I was in the top 1,000 last month, and I think you can only, as far as I know, you can only, or like, okay, so basically, sorry, my mind is kind of in different places. For being in the top 1,000, what you get is you get access to, like, the next MCQ tournament here on Arena, but I think that it's, you know, for a couple, like, everybody from month A gets in and everybody from month B gets in. And I, you know, since I qualified in month A, I don't think month B gives you anything extra. I think month B is just like the same invitation that I would still get from month A, kind of thing.
Here, be monster. Your crew for my
GG.
A fair price.
I said -3. I need to sacrifice this Krasis so it doesn't come back to him. I don't want them to have that crisis. So I did this, the very classic act of treason, sacrificing your own creature. Classic limited strat. There. Nope. Let's see. Let me see if, yeah, I'll find it for you here. Where is this deck? Here it is. No, Angrath has no other text besides just deal the creature. Angrath has no other text at all. Oh, there you go. Thanks, Prugor. But yeah, there's that deck list there. That's a really nice deck list. That's like one of my favorite decks right now. Okay. But yeah, GG's, c'est moi. Yeah, I had very good hands there. And yeah, you had the mold of 5 game 2, unfortunately. Sorry about that. All right, if you are a subscriber and you'd like to be the next person to play, go ahead and type battle into the chat here. And we'll see who is up next. Oh, you're going to mass manipulate for 2? You had 1 more mana? Dang. Alright, looks like everybody got in there. So who's going to be up next? Debo 4. All right, Debo. You know the gamer. You know the drill. Send me that gamer tag. And let's see what deck I am playing. Ooh, I am playing the finale of Zitalpa. This is a really fun donation deck we had just a few days ago. Nope, no other text on Angrath besides just deal the creature. That's it. Doing the playcraft remove was definitely worth it. All right, so finale of Zitalpa looks like this. It's basically a green ramp deck with, you know, we're basically just trying to ramp and have Finale of Devastation for 10 and put in Zitalpa off the Finale of Devastation. So that's our plan here. That's our deck. All right, Debo, you have your gamer tag? Ugh. All right, cool. All right, good luck. It's knotted up at 1-1. All my beautiful gems, they went towards cosmetics. Yeah, all these expensive cosmetics. I think we can keep this hand. You know, we need green mana, but we have the chart, of course. That should help us get green mana. It's a pretty cool island. Uh-oh. So next turn I play Gift to Paradise. Yeah, I think I'm just not playing this Incubation Druid. Uh-oh. Ow. So. Uh-oh. Okay, so Krasis is for 3 this turn. If I Finale of Devastation for 3, I don't think I'm really getting anything. I think there's Ripjaw Raptors in this deck that I can grab at 4. So like next turn I can go grab my own Ripjaw Raptor with the Finale of Devastation. Yeah, White Korean, this is your deck. Yep. Hmm. maybe I should just be playing the Nissa and the Llanowar Elf and just chump locking with the Llanowar Elf kind of thing. Yeah, because that's lethal. I guess it wouldn't have been... Yeah, that could have been... That maybe would have let me stay alive. And then win the next turn, honestly. So if I would have played Nissa and Llanowar Elf, I could have had a creature, a 3-3 to block with... Like, I could have blocked a 1-1 with the 3-3 land. We couldn't let the land die. And then the Llanowar Elf could just jump block the 4-5 there. I would have gone to 1. And the next turn, if I would have drawn a forest, we would have been able to Zatalpa. We would have been able to Finale Devastation for Zatalpa, and we would have won the next turn if I would have just drawn a forest. I guess I don't really have too much for this matchup. Thorn Lieutenant doesn't really even match up that well. That was just a really good hand that Debo had there with, you know, Llanowar Elf on 1, Spellbreaker on 2, Ripjaw on 3. Tough hand to deal with. Rebuke, Manipulation, or like options. I think Manipulation would be the card I'd be the most interested in. I don't think I really want it though. Because of, like, the haste creatures. Not sure if I want to be rebuking. Yeah, Llanowar turn one, you might as well scoop. That is true. Alright, the good old 3-mana Llanowar Elf. Light's so big. Why is Null Height so big? Man, I think that smash hurt so bad. Yeah, Gruul curving out is rough. Team chat with the win is now 2-1. GG's there, Debo. GG's. On my side, no, I kept a one lander. I drew two lands in a row, which was really lucky. You know, like I scryed the second land at the top. But I love it. GG's Diva4. All right, let's see who is up next. That's it. Stream's over. 2-1. Okay. Of course, you know, just for subscribers here. Let's see who we got. Hey, Matu. You think Team Chat needs a better name? I like Team Chat. Mercer. All right, Mercer, send me that gamer tag. And there's mine. I'll go ahead and let the wheel decide what I'm going to be playing here. What deck am I playing? Ooh, I'm zapping. With Dimir Tesserator. Get some zapping in. Alright, so Dimir Tesserator. Don't know this deck too well. It's basically just blue-black control trying to zap with the Master of the Bridge. That's what we got. Alright, here's Mercer. We're gonna do challenge match, best of three. And here we go. Team Cat. Team Hawkeye. Okay, well, it doesn't have, like, any interaction. So I'm going to get run over. If Mercer has an aggressive start here, I'm getting run over. But Guild Globe's good. Looks like I'm getting run over. Instead of going treasure map here so I can scry, I'm going with the Guild Globe. Because I want to be playing the Saheeli the next turn. I don't want to be spending the mana to scry. I just want the extra card immediately. Jeskai Hero. Punish. I was thinking about doing that on upkeep. I was just kind of lazy. Like, that should be a move that I should be just doing on upkeep, though. Oh, I guess that's the reason to do it right now, because otherwise I'd have to discard. Those are flying thopters. Wow, nobody ever respects a Healy. Guildgate. It's better than not a land, I suppose. So I'm just gonna bounce one of these 1/1s. I kinda think I will. Slow that clock down. Hmm.
There is great power in the things we make.
More artifacts.
I like to think fast.
Attack. Looks like Mercer just flooded out. Yeah, team chat's in the lead.
I know my responsibility. This might be a bad idea.
Surprised that was the one that was bounced. Oh. Okay. Role reversal. Interesting.
I am perfection, both body and mind.
Allow me to introduce you to a friend of mine. I will fight.
Karn going crazy.
Awaken.
Zap.
This is just the beginning.
Some lessons for you all.
Tezzeret is sweet.
That didn't go according to plan.
This deck's cool. It's fun to play. I mean, it really helped that Mercer just had basically nothing going on after I killed the heroes. Yeah, that animation, though, that's one of the best animations. It's the reason to play the deck, for sure. That animation's super cool. All right, I think we're going to want some Ritual of Soots against Hero. I'll take out a Fountain of Renewal. And I'll get another spyglass instead of a fountain, instead of the fountain there. Maybe I just want a moment of craving instead of a ritual. We'll go with that. Yeah, you have to go through like that. Yeah, the decks there. You can find it. You know, look for Dimir Tesserator from a few days ago. If you'd like this list. Hero got fanged. Don't want this hero coming back. No extra 1/1s.
I am not going to sit this one out. Trust me, I have a plan.
Chance for Glory and Deputy. The chance for glory doing in here.
You've never seen anything like this.
Hey, Chameleon. Yeah, I guess so. I just know, this was just like the shirt that I felt like wearing today. And yeah, I guess it does. It is. I guess I am wearing like the red, white, blue almost. Yeah, I guess so. I didn't really even notice that. Uh-oh. This time it was my turn to flood out. Well, I didn't really like flood out more than Mircer did here. It's just really the Dovin and the hero are doing more than the two Sahelis are.
You will not dissuade me from battle.
I can benefit from another's success.
Is destruction your only art?
This hero's just never gonna get out of here.
What an interesting creature. Let's see how you work.
Not just
a whole bunch of thopters with his Dovin's pretty sweet. All right, so I'm definitely going to need another Ritual of Soot in my deck. All right, so I'm going to have to put in the other Ritual of Soot.
This technique is perfect.
Hey, what's up, Phaser? Thanks for that sub there. Well, I shouldn't have said that I did not flood out more than my opponent, because at the time, you know, we had the same lands, but then I drew two lands.
Cease this.
Since then, I drew two lands and a Tyrant Scorn. Tyrant Scorn being good. But over there, the two deploys. Not so good for me. No, do I want another treasure map next turn? No. Looks like I'm dead with Dovin ultimating.
Most situations, no matter how dire, are easily remedied.
Thanks, Phaser. Yeah, so we'll be doing this. So this is every last Saturday of the month. There's only one last Saturday of the month. Why can't I ever say this correctly? Or say it not so confusing. So the last Saturday of every month. There we go. That sounds better. And that's when we're going to be doing the sub-battle stream.
With a new plan.
So I'm gonna need Ritual of Soot. All All right, let's try this again. See if I can find some Karns or Tezzerets. Deck isn't so good if I don't find any Karns or Tezzerets. Water Grave's a good one, though. Or sorry, not Water Grave. Treasure Map. Oh, my mind today. Treasure Map's a good one. All right, so game three. I'll lead with Gilglub, because I think I'll probably be going Saheeli next turn. We'll get that extra card immediately. Gosh. Just always turn to hero. So now I don't really want to lead with Saheeli next. Now I really guess I want to do this. Jeez. I'm just dead. Not beating this. All right, looks like chat's going to be up 1-3, 3-1. Going to have my work cut out for me here.
Prepare to marvel at my masterpieces.
I'm really, really dead to this heroic reinforcements. I'm not going to be able to stop that really either. All right, GG's. Good job, Mercer. Good games. Hey, Caddy. All right, team chat is up 3-1. All right, so if you're a... so let's see who's up next. So if you're a subscriber, you'd like to be the next person to play, go ahead and just type the word battle into the chat. That's all you gotta do. Just gotta be a subscriber. Type the word battle. Yeah, game two, I didn't have anything besides Saheeli's. I just had lands and Saheeli's. And so I didn't have any. You know, like, I got the treasure map really late, but yeah, I didn't have those or Karns or Tezzerets or anything. And yeah, your curve game two, I couldn't handle either. All I had were treasure maps and Saheeli. Okay, looks like everybody's in there. Who is up? Phaser. Well, there you go. Phaser is our newest resub here, and Phaser gets to battle the very next match. Set Phaser to top deck. There you go. All right, let's go ahead and spin the wheel, see what deck I'm playing up next. I'm getting some mono green action going on. Love it, time to stomp. All right, time to stomp, stomp, stomp. This is our mono green deck. It is the... We don't quite have M20 Vivian yet, but we're going to build a deck still around, like, with M20 Vivian in mind, even though we don't have that card out yet. Deck. All right, good little curve. Nickel Bullets, we're going down. We need some defense here. We're down 3-1.
How this thing goes is up to you, pal. For the Fallen.
All right, the Steel Leaf Champion. That's what I need right now. Need a champion. One eye open to see the truth of the world. One eye covered to gaze at the goddess within.
The mysteries of life are endless.
It's not really the flavor text I would expect for a Steel Leaf Champion.
Like the phases of the moon, life waxes and wanes. I know I noted this somewhere.
Well, that's a pretty good life. Unfortunately, I'm basically wasting the Steel Leaf Champion here. Sorry, the Ronas. I'm wasting the Ronas here. I just need to kill this Tamiyo that just has so much loyalty. Like, why does that have to have 6 loyalty to start with? Yeah, I don't really have... Like, this deck... Like, this deck is just kind of built to beat control decks kind of thing, or like aggro decks. I don't have any interaction. I can't be Wild Growth into double Jade Light Ranger. I can't beat that with this deck. Well, the new Chandra is at a 6 mana Planeswalker, right? So 6 mana, 8 loyalty. It is, I guess that is still a lot, but it's 6 mana. Karn had like 10 loyalty.
Strike now! Strike hard!
Please don't attack my Vivian. Nope, yeah, you exile the card face down, so no. Opponent doesn't see anything here. Thank you.
Wait, you think nature is kind?
Go, Ronas, go. This is like the worst matchup for my deck. It's a very, very bad matchup. Looks like we're gonna be 1-4.
I will aid.
By we, I mean me. Sorry. Y'all are 4-1. Y'all are doing great. This game's been over for a while. Ever since the Tamiyo took up Fine Tooth Jade Lights, the game was over. I'm just kind of playing it out for keep up appearances and everything. Yeah. Barely survived that long stream yesterday. That was a close one.
Let me show you what was lost.
This is about the best my deck can be doing, to be honest. Krasis comes down, kills me. Alright, I'm gonna need Galta to help me out here. So Vinemare, Thorn Lieutenant, some cards that aren't good here. Like Vinemare just trades with Merfolk Branchwalker. It's really, really bad in these matchups. But it's kind of the whole point of my deck. So taking it out is kind of rough. I guess I just try to throw a whole bunch of forests out there. I think Harpoon, honestly, I kind of think Harpooner is going to be too small to kill Krasis. But maybe not. Maybe it can. No, I couldn't race. I had no chance of winning that game. All right, Vitellius. Have a good weekend. Probably, I think sealed. Yeah, if you like playing sealed, Lord Dracus, I think that's probably the way to go. Getting the $50 pre-order pack is really not. It's really not much better than just buying packs in general. You know, it is by a little bit, but not much.
Would you like to see what's left of Scum? Starting over is the only way.
And so if you like playing sealed, that's a better way to go. Well, bad news, our Steely Champion's dead, but good news, we get a much needed extra land. Zavizi.
You fight like a city brat.
Vivian's kind of rude. I don't know exactly what you get with the mastery upgrade and everything. I'm pretty excited to see what that's all about. But no, I don't know exactly what that's all about. Opportunity for new data.
Let me aid your research.
But yeah, we'll kind of find out more about that like on Tuesday and everything. It looks pretty good. It looks like a better thing than like than what we have right now.
I've seen puppies whine less than you.
I don't know very much about the mastery stuff. There's a new on Tuesday whenever M20 is released. It's a new reward system. Instead of the just getting 3 packs a week for 15 wins, which is what they have right now, where you know every Sunday you can get, you know, starting then you can earn 3 new booster packs. There's going to be like something that they call a mastery system.
I think you will find my
where there are like 2 tracks, and 1 track is for free, you know, anybody, you know, just extra rewards and everything. And then there's another track that if you'd like to pay for like an upgrade kind of thing, then you earn more rewards.
The land shall conquer you.
Well, looks like I stole a game here. All right, stole a game. I guess I didn't even realize I could have just, yeah, played Harpooner and then Galta.
I said I realized that. That would have been better instead of Dullhide. Yeah, that would have been better.
All right, well, I've had 2 amazing hands so far. You know, both with Llanowar Elf and a really good curve. Can I get a third one? Well, this is amazing if I draw a bunch of lands. It's a risk I'm willing to take with a matchup like this. I'm not going to be... I don't know if a 6-card hand is going to be worth going to be winning. I think there's a better chance. Like, on the play, I wouldn't be keeping this, but we're on the draw. Better chance I just draw a couple lands. Hey, Eisenf. So now that you did the site review, what do you think are the chances for a deck with a lot of artifacts and Tezzeret Master of the Bridge? Do you think it might be a decent deck? I mean, it kind of really depends on how you define decent. I don't think it would be anything like at the top of the metagame. Disdainful Stroke makes me want to play Nullhide here, but if I play Nullhide, I can't play Vivian. I just can't beat Wildgrowth Walker, Jade Light Ranger. I just can't beat that. It's so good. Yeah, this deck could use removal in the sideboard. I didn't build this deck to try to win this matchup. This was an anti-Esper deck. The mastery system is also free, Akaiza's, and you'll be earning packs with that also. So no, tomorrow's. No, you're going to be getting free packs still. It's a new system to do rewards. Like for the rewards, it's just a new system. I just gotta hope that Phaser never draws a Krasis.
The land fights for us.
Well, and then I guess I don't really know. I need Goreclaw. What's Goreclaw even doing for me? I need like Goreclaw in play, and then play Ronus after that to double the power and make them all trample.
Every fight makes me stronger. All things begin and end in nature.
I don't really have a chance.
Behold, nature's true power.
Rough matchup there. All right, GG's. GG's there. All right, so chat is up 4-1 now. So if you would like to be the next person to play. Good games, Phaser. Thank you so much. Good games. All right, go ahead and type. If you're a subscriber, you'd like to be the next person to play, go ahead and type battle into the chat there. Yeah, I had nothing for that matchup, honestly. I got lucky to steal a game with amazing hands, but that's a matchup I think I would lose 95 times out of 100. Probably. All right. So I got some work to do to come on back here. But also been, the wheel has hit some of my lower power decks so far. All right, everybody's in there. Eisenath. Hey! Sothia, not only with the party time cheer, but then Boot gifting the sub out to be Golem. Getting the hype in the channel. Thank you so much, Boot. No, it looks like the wheel got refreshed, but no, I'm not going to be playing any duplicates. It usually can't get the decks get deleted off of the wheel every time I choose it, but it looks like, yeah, see, there's Mono Green Stomp again. I think I accidentally hit, like, the refresh or something, because, like, those decks that I already played are still back on there. Yeah, it's supposed to remove the choice after it's landed on. All right, Rakdos Zombies. So yeah, if I hit one of the decks I've already played, I'll redo it. All right, where's Rakdos Zombies? Here we go. Okay, I don't have that Angrath. All right. There's my Rakdos Zombie deck. No, Teferi players don't get instantly banned. The Sultai deck's good. Yeah, that's a good strong deck there. That was the second best deck I've played so far was the Sultai deck. Okay, mono black. Like, this could be mono black chromatic lantern deck. Can a pile of 1-mana 2/1s take down the game? The answer is no. Almost had it, but nope. Main deck Cry of the Canarium got me pretty good there. I guess maybe I should have just bedeviled that treasure map that was about to flip. Let's see, there's another Cry of the Carnarium here. Alright, so did I get a couple of triggers? Game number two. So I have to make sure that I'm not so bad against Cry of the Carnarium, or at least not as bad against Cry of the Carnarium. The problem is like, you know, kind of the strength of my deck is like the Death Barons and the Judiths, and they're both just horrible against Cry of the Carnarium. So if I cut all of those, if I cut all of them, don't really need these lightning strikes. Looks like I'll play one. Would I rather have Death Baron or Judith? I guess Judith. All right, let's try this. The 4-mana Angrath can make a couple creatures with a minus ability. Can amass. Alright, Liliana looks like we're never casting. We'll kind of see here. Well, that's that was my whole plan. There goes everything. All right, so drawing the three lands is definitely good for getting towards Liliana Dreadhorde General. Of course, Ugin can kill Liliana, though, so it wouldn't be the worst if I let have Ugin resolve first and bedevil Ugin, and then Liliana afterwards.
Ramming speed.
There is always another fight.
Yeah, I was all in with that butcher. Go, Liliana, go.
If I were you. Good help is easy to find in war.
Yeah, the Angrath, this Angrath was pretty nice, you know, making a 4-4 that killed the Karn. Really holding back. There's like a, you know, ritual of soot here. You know, Cry of the Carnarium doesn't kill the 5/5 at least, but ritual of soot. We still have the Liliana alive. Kind of thing. Yeah, Hawkeye's got a little short tail. But you know, like the finale of Eternity is kind of having me. Commit a little bit more to the board. Ritual said was the worst possible thing for me, but let's refill this hand. Ooh, Angrath.
They were a lousy servant. I'll find a use for you later.
Here be monsters. No fire. No steel.
This looks like a fun new toy.
Whoops. Meant to play the Mobilized District. I don't play the wrong land there. Yeah. I'm blaming Hawkeye, who is walking across. Yeah, I meant to play the Mobilized District. Just kind of played the wrong land. Yeah. Alright, so Liliana down, because, yeah, Liliana was going to ultimate, so gotta go after Liliana. There.
No fire, no steel. Another.
So, still looking good. You know, could have had lethal if I would have played the district last turn, but yeah. Yeah, when Boots not around, it's the cat's fault. Otherwise, it's Boots' fault. All right. Yeah, Mobilized District has Summoning Sickness. Hey, Zeet. Cool. Yeah, glad you like the Gruul Arcbow deck. Awesome. Every creature has Summoning Sickness. Doesn't matter if it's a land that turns into a creature, or a planeswalker, or an artifact, an enchantment, you know, anything like that. Any of those things that can turn into creatures, they all still have Summoning Sickness. Unless, you know, unless it says it has haste, specifically. not winning a long game, so I'm just gonna, you know, just kind of test, see if there's Cry of the Carnarium. Not playing scared. All right, no land. Yeah, summoning sickness are things that attack, not all permanents, but just things that attack, like creatures. Kind of thing.
I will fight. My purpose is greater than myself. You are only hurting yourself.
All right, Dreadhorde invasion. Gotta help me out here.
Warrior Queen Necromancer. Get out of my way.
Bleh.
Some solutions must be built. My allies are counting on me.
Rise and shine.
I am dead.
Want not.
I am ancient, and ether itself serves me.
Putrid, but effective.
Evil cannot withstand a righteous heart.
All right, team chat picking up another win. And team chat is now up 5-1. GG's. Team chat's crushing it. Doing great. All right, who's up next? So again, 4 subscribers there. There you go. Yeah, good game there, Eisenf. GG's. All right, so if you're a subscriber, you'd like to be the next person to play, go ahead and type battle into the chat. All right. We'll see you back, Eisenf. Yep, all you have to do, Mad Cow, is just type battle into the chat. And you see like that paragraph right there, you can kind of read there. Yep, there you go. That's all you gotta do. No, I'm playing random decks. That's how it works. I like all of these decks. I'm not playing decks I don't like. All right, looks like everybody got in there, so let's see who's up next. Oh, Sonic Bob. Oh. I guess Angry Ben's not a subscriber. Sorry. Let's try it again. Yeah, of course you can post it, Eisenf. You're good. All right, Oslin, you are up next. All right, so send me that gamer tag. Here's my gamer tag. Because if you just write the word battle in your message, you enter in to be one of the people to subscribe. So you said no battle for me. So, not subscribe, but yeah, you enter to be one of the people that wins. Kind of thing. Okay, let's spin the wheel. Let's see what deck I'll be playing here. Ooh, 5-color Reborn. All right, this is a good deck. All right, 5-color Reborn. That's what we got here. Yeah, played Rakdos Zombies last match. Yep. All right, here we go. I can keep this. Got two lands. And Discovery. Discovery being a really key card to have. So much aggression here. You have to say, yeah, you have to redo it each time, Mad Cow. It's a new, I do a, you know, basically a new giveaway each time so that people aren't still in it, you know, 3 hours later whenever, you know, they're gone and done something else. And then, you know, we choose them and then try to figure out where they are and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, it's just, it's a new one every time. Yeah, Judith Priest is in, I think that's in here. I'm pretty sure it's in here. This is one of the deck choices. Sacrifice a Planeswalker. So, I think I can stabilize with the help of a Johnny gaining 3 life a turn. I think so. We'll kind of see. Was a good card to play there. Stay with the Krasis instead of the Niv-Mizzet, because Krasis gains that life. You know, so one of that two life there. Yeah, Garter Bones is a good one, for sure. Don't need that or that. Teferi.
I will teach you humility.
Now do you see the benefits of peace?
Yeah, that's the second time that we've seen somebody in chat play Revival today. That was like a perfect card to draw.
Sorry, I'm late. I'll protect you.
That was a good draw.
Oh, I've done the hero thing before.
I'm gonna need to.
Now do you see the benefits of peace?
We need to find another one of my creatures.
Light shall always conquer darkness.
No, I am not making this up as I go.
Just slow him down another turn from bringing all these gutter bones back.
Now do you see the benefits of peace?
Yeah, I didn't think about Clarion Instant Speed, honestly. I guess I could have done that. I need a Krasis or a Niv-Mizzet. I have five left, seen three of those. You know, there's eight in the deck. Krasis and Niv-Mizzet's, we've seen three. Ooh, Celebrant, that's a cruel card. Man, I'd be so dead if it wasn't for this Ajani. I'd be so dead.
I'll taste your neck.
Soren was a great, great draw. There goes Ajani. It's unfortunate. Can I sacrifice this Chromatic Lantern No, I don't. I don't like bow ties. I don't like how they look. I like regular ties. Yeah, Golas is going into this deck, yeah. Golas is awesome.
I require your body, not your soul.
That's a top deck right there. Yeah, I was considering dispersal. I couldn't dispersal and trophy though.
Now, do you see the benefits of peace?
Yeah, that Niv-Miz, it's a crazy draw. It drew me, it was a 6-6 flyer that also killed their 1-2 that also drew me a Krasis and a Teferi. Back-to-back Sorens, though, are crazy. Well, finally grabbed the Playcrafter.
See the benefits
back up to close to 20. Oh, one of your Nivs whiffed earlier. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Rex. Yeah, I don't know how. Yeah, we'll see how our opponent's dealing with this 10-10. I mean, I definitely have to get rid of the Sorin now. I can't let them get Playcrafter again, of course. But yeah, give it Vigilance. 10-10 flying Vigilant Trample. Thanks to the Ajani giving it Vigilance. There's four Nivs. Yeah, there's four Nivs, four Krasis.
This isn't a fight you can.
Let's skip to the good part. triumph of the weak.
Oh, Celebrant triggers off of Planeswalkers? Forgot about that.
Now, do you see the benefits of peace?
If I would have a minus to Johnny there, I'd put the Teferi up to, you know, like, I can kind of be minusing the Johnny to try to get the Teferi to ultimate faster. So I save one life by blocking, but they gain a life. But just trade a life with them by blocking. A little surprised no attack at Teferi.
Let's take it.
Because the Teferi gets rid of that priest. 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's do 8. Wow, Johnny was awesome for us. And some people are like, why don't you just play a Tristani? Tristani's so much better. I don't like this at Johnny. It's what I hear all the time. No, Johnny's great. Won us that game on its own. Yeah, the vigilance also. Yep. Yeah, giving like the big creatures vigilance is certainly valuable. Do I need to unmoored ego away the gutter bones? May need to do that. Hey, Hawkeye. How you doing? No, I don't think I'd really want to be having Saheeli too much. Like I guess here in this kind of matchup though, like the 1/1s are important against a deck that's going this small. But for the most part, I don't think I would really want the Saheeli too much. The Scudder Bones is just so good. Just can't ever get rid of it. Gotta be another plague crafter over there in Oslin's hand, I'm thinking. Four discoveries were there. We just drew a discovery, and then there's three more discoveries. Ooh, not another playcrafter. That's gonna be the. That's one of my new movies coming out. It's the sequel to. I don't know. Some other movie, but not another playcrafter. And this is where Clarion acts like double duty, gives my Limvisit life link, gain some of that life back. So 7 mana right now. Not another playcrafter. Okay. Well, we'll see what Krasis can do. All the sweet buzz. Yeah, you get to play whatever. Yeah, you get to play whatever deck you want, Mad Cow. Yeah, you can play a jank deck for sure. Yeah, you can do play whatever you want. Yeah, the timely duress. There. All right, Niv-Mizzet. Paired up with Nicol Bolas for the win there. GG's Oslin. GG's there. All right, and here's the start of a comeback. Niv always wins. Niv wins it. There we go. Is that it? Niv wins it. All right. So if you're a subscriber, type battle in the chat if you want to be up next. All right, Oslin, have a great weekend. I'll see you on Tuesday. No, Igrak. No. All right, let's see who's up. Night's Watch. All right, Night's Watch. Send me that gamer tag. Here's my gamer tag. Let's see what deck I'm playing. The Party Bus. Whew. A little early on in a Saturday for the Party Bus, but looks like that's what we got. The Party Bus versus the Night's Watch. All right. I'm trying to copy paste this, but I'm struggling here. Copy. All right, there we go. All right, where's our Party Bus? I feel like I'm missing it. There it is. So this is the Party Bus deck. We're trying to make as many battlements as we can. The battlement is our Party Bus. We're trying to clone it, make a bunch of them, go infinite, and mill. Party Bus going hard. No, bringing in main deck to Kali Honor Guard. No. I don't really want to, Jacob. I haven't been asked to, but it's not something I really want to do anyway. It's a day that has, you know, like hundreds and hundreds of streamers on. It's not like a very, I don't know, that's just, you know, not a day that I really want to. I'd rather just relax, take the day off, and then the next day, when it's out for everybody and you have like all the events and everything, I want to play then. All right, Night's Watch. Finding where to connect. Okay, go to here. Sorry, up at the top corner, like right here, direct challenge, click that for the direct challenge and make sure you have it on challenge match and then best of three and then coin flip. So challenge match, best of three, coin flip for your three options there. So yeah, make sure you have those options selected. Perfect. Here we go. Yeah, I know the camera hides it, so I have to read it or I have to say it, you know, said it aloud. But okay, well if I draw an explore creature, my hand's looking a lot better. All right. I don't want to really mirror image the Wild Growth Walker, I don't think. Because without having any explore creatures, the Wild Growth Walker isn't really doing anything. So just copying it without any hope of drawing explore creatures right now isn't something I want to do. Ooh. Okay. We got like a 5-color deck here. I'm gonna need to reset arena after this round, I think. Plus, I want to save this for the bus anyway. Adding mana of any color with everything. Everything's adding mana of any color. That must be pretty valuable, having mana of any color.
The wilds are my shield.
The bus. Yeah, I could see this being Niv-Mizzet. Yeah. Yeah, this could be a Niv-Mizzet deck. So it's a 4-card infinite combo that needs 3 battlements.
I always survive.
Dang.
You'll see.
Three battlements in the Wall of Lost Thoughts. So we got the 3 battlements now. So I need the Wall of Lost Thoughts. And I need to play them all and have them not die. And everything too.
I will defend my stand down.
Nah, that did almost make me swear. I don't swear. Thuran Temporal Gateway? Alright, now we're talking.
You can't stop nature.
Let's get a backup bus. Yeah, I got this Vivian here to check the gateway. Keep the gateway in check.
True goodness can never be corrupted.
This plus one untap. No, oh, I meant to minus. Like I whoops. Oh no. Oh no. I was thinking about that plus one ability, but yeah, I just forgot to do the whole minus thing. Whoops. They are quilting. For example, this is the last time that we did it. That was part one, and you know, it's 3-part thing. Yeah, they're on there. I don't know. See? YouTube channel, all the videos. See? Sub battle stream. Yeah. They're up there. All right, Vivian's gone. I could do the double mirror image of the battleman. I could draw infinite cards right now. An excellent informant for my to the library. But I wouldn't be able to, like, stop, you know, I wouldn't be able to, like, stop the combo. To win the game. I'll just look for this wall. The last time, like, the last sub-battle streams that are up on YouTube are from 2 weeks ago, from the last time that we had the sub-battle stream. There's not any from today.
Seek and find.
Up there yet?
There is great power in the-
Yeah, War of the Spark was pretty OP.
I know I noted this somewhere.
Yay. Alright, we'll see if Night's Watch has instant speed removal over there. Oh, I'm one mana short. I'm a mana short anyway. So I guess I'll just play this other one. And do it next turn. Wait, I need mana. What am I doing? Get rid of that. Yeah, they get to put in Nissa here. I wonder... Yeah, so they're going to have a whole lot of mana next turn. Wonder what Night Watch is going to do with so much mana. The Gateway, the Karn that can mine us. I wonder what's going to go on here. Oh, didn't activate Gateway? They could have end stepped activated Gateway, put in Nissa. No, Cody, it doesn't.
Which cannot protect itself.
No, our opponent had four mana. They had the lantern, a land, a druid, and prowler. Night's Watch had all those.
The past is never forgotten.
I will not stop.
There's some crazy stuff going on over here. Yep, now we wombo combo. Parhelion! Yeah. All right, now our turn to combo. This is like the slowest combo also. All right, 35 cards. And now his watch has ended. All right, I should probably just stop exiling these other things. Yeah, just make this faster instead of getting all these other triggers. All right, we'll just... All right, so I'm just gonna do the wall and the battlement so we don't, so it doesn't take forever. Vraska? Muldratha. All right, we got down to 15 cards. We're getting there. Slow combo. So what happens when there's too many party buses? You're hopping from bus to bus, hopping from party bus to party bus. You eventually, you know, get a little slower. And there we go. I don't know if I want to change anything. Nah. That's great. Hey, Zalay, I'm doing good. How are you doing? Yeah, long time. Hope you're doing good. Hey, thanks, Dark Metaphors. Thanks for the cheers there. The Night's Watch loses to a wall. I missed that. Yeah, that is pretty ironic. The Night's Watch is losing, just lost to a wall. The Night's Watch is a wall. My favorite deck these days? Maybe the Mardu midrange, I have to say. Deck's a lot of fun. This deck right here. Hey, good. Good job, Zelay. Got to Mythic. Way to go. Alright, we just got a good... Explorer hand here. Gonads and Strife with the sub there. Welcome to the channel. Thank you so much for that support there. Oh no, Night's Watch is... Missed a land drop. Meanwhile, my hand is perfect here. It's just a perfect explore hand. All right, now they're going. Man, that was a violent attack. Ooh, okay. That's what Night's Watch needed. We got a game. We got a game here. The good old 5-for-1 Ritual of Soot.
Let's see if you're worthy. Every defeat is a new beginning.
Can they stabilize? Alright, got the Prowler.
Meet my newest friend.
Alright, with them being kind of stuck on mana, I just want to get rid of their mana creature. So just do the trade and play the Battlement. Yeah, I guess I could have just killed the lantern also. With the spark doubling the lantern, spark doubling the Vivian to kill the lantern. Well, pretty fun match there. Got to do the combo. Game one, and yeah, battling back. Two straight wins here. GG's there, Nightwatch. Good games. All right. I guess we are close to 3 hours in here to this recording, so I should probably stop it and start a new recording for the YouTube channel. So if you're watching this on YouTube, thank you so much for watching. Make sure you head on over to part two of the sub battle stream. See if I can work my way back. And yeah, see you then. Click on over there.